Today, we are continuing our series. We're talking about one player from every single NFL team that is currently being undervalued in fantasy football. Someone that I believe will outperform their average draft position. And we've talked about a lot of divisions. Today, we are covering the NFC East. We're talking about the Cowboys, the Giants, the Eagles, the Washington football team. We're going to cover all of those, pick one player from every single team that will outperform their ADP currently in ESPN snake drafts. Now, I appreciate it if you subscribe to the channel. I got all the other divisions linked down below. We've covered about five of them so far, so only two more left, which we'll cover next week. But today, we're starting with the Eagles, and I'm going with their quarterback, Jalen Hurts, currently being drafted as QB 11, pick 108. Now, Jalen Hurts, he's got a lot of criticism, a lot of doubters this offseason, and I feel like it's all tied to his 52% completion percentage last year. People see that, and they're just running away, saying, this guy can't be an NFL quarterback. Now, I gotta say, he's a better quarterback than that. For starters, he threw the ball deep more than the average quarterback, contributing to this low, you know, completion percentage. And also, this was a rookie QB that was just thrown into the system. Like, the majority of the season, he was used as a gadget player, someone that would come in, run the ball, maybe do an option or something along those lines. He was hardly used to throw the ball or actually prepare for an NFL offense. He was just thrust into the role of starting quarterback and did pretty well, at least fantasy football-wise. And it's very similar to a guy named Lamar Jackson, who did the same thing his rookie year, was just behind Joe Flacco, just hanging out, and then he finally got thrust into the spotlight. And look what he did in his second NFL season. You know, he only played a couple games, but second NFL season, Lamar Jackson won MVP. So free the Jalen Hurts MVP wagon. That's what, I'm not necessarily saying he's going to win MVP, but you got to look at it. Jalen Hurts was very good fantasy football wise. During the final four games, Hurts ran for 272 yards, three touchdowns, and he was the seventh best quarterback in fantasy football. The sky's the limit for this guy in terms of fantasy. He's a very hard worker. His teammates quote him saying, you know, what he does at practice and what he does in the hallways, asking him about the playbooks and all that jazz. This guy is due for a great NFL season and a great fantasy football season. He not only throws the ball a lot, he'll be running the ball a lot, and that's what you need in a top quarterback. It's very hard to be a top 10 quarterback without giving you something on your legs. And I don't think there will be many more quarterbacks in the NFL that run more than someone like Jalen Hurts. And that's why I'm trying to get him. He's currently being undervalued. QB 11, absolutely not. He'll finish as a top 10 QB, guaranteed. Moving on to the Washington football team. Talk about their tight end, Logan Thomas, currently being drafted as tight end 7, pick 77. Lots of sevens. Now, Logan Thomas, he was a breakout tight end of 2020, and he was like the, not Darren Waller, but Darren Waller was a breakout tight end of 2019. That was Logan Thomas last year, as he flourished as tight end 3 in PPR, scoring 72 receptions, 670 yards, and 6 touchdowns. And he ended the season 6 straight games with double-digit scoring points, and 9 out of his last 11 fantasy weeks, he scored double-digit points. Now, think back to last year. Washington, very, very shaky quarterback play. No disrespect to Kyle Allen, Dwayne Haskins, Alex Smith, and company. They were not that good. Now, this year, they got a new QB under center, Ryan Fitzpatrick, who I am high on. I've talked to him various times in videos. I am high on him, at least to be better than those guys. And it's more so, I'm not necessarily saying, you know, Ryan Fitzpatrick is better than all those guys, which I would say he probably is, but he's led a lot of good fantasy football offenses and good NFL offenses in general. You think about his time with the Jets and the Dolphins and even with the Bucks, he led very good offenses. And I think he'll do that same thing in Washington. Now, you look at it, there's Thomas here. Logan Thomas, he's going to be probably the last consistent fantasy football tight end currently going in drafts, going right behind someone like TJ Hockenson and Kyle Pitts. And then you got the other guys like Kittle, Waller, Kelsey, and Mark Andrews. But you look at him, he's getting taken right before the Noah Fants, the Robert Tonyans, the Dallas Goddards, Mike Gesicki's of the world. All these guys have question marks. They're very tight end or bust. I feel like Logan Thomas, you're going to expect 5-plus targets, if not more, every single game. And Washington, they gave him a nice contract, so they're going to use him in the passing game. And they even got a couple more weapons on the outside to open it up a little bit more for Logan Thomas. And that's what I'm all in. You saw what Ryan Fitzpatrick was able to do with Mike Gesicki last year. Won't be surprised to see the same thing for Logan Thomas, who's very sneakily athletic. And I think he'll have a very good fantasy football season. Currently being drafted as tight end 7. Don't mind taking him of like maybe even over TJ Hockenson, you know, who I also do like, but TJ Hockenson going a full round or two ahead of him. Don't mind snagging Logan Thomas. And he's like my last guy. I need to have him, or else I might as well wait, because I'm throwing a dart anyways at the tight end position. Moving on to the Cowboys. Now, I could have talked about CeeDee Lamb in this position, and maybe if I was 3 months earlier, probably could, but CeeDee Lamb all the way up to wide receiver 11, pick 34 in fantasy drafts. Yeah, no chance. Now, I know a lot of people are high on him with the return of Dak Prescott. A lot of people are high on this Cowboys offense, and that's because of Dak Prescott returning. We saw how good they were in the first 4 weeks while Dak was healthy last year, constantly playing in shootouts, and they were absolutely absurd. So I'm not going to talk about Dak because he's a top 6 QB. Not going to talk about CeeDee Lamb because he's risen up the draft board to wide receiver 11, which is absolutely insane. And then there's Ezekiel Elliott, top 6 running back. So who am I going to go to? They're first, I don't know why he's being their second wide receiver drafted. Amari Cooper, currently being drafted wide receiver 15, ADP pick 45, going a full 11 picks after his teammate, CeeDee Lamb. Now, Amari Cooper's no slouch. There's few receivers in the league that are better than this guy. This guy was wide receiver 15 in PPR last year, that with 92 receptions, 1,100 yards, and 5 touchdowns. And that was with the QB carousel after Dak Prescott went down. It was just Ben DiNucci, Andy Dalton, and all those guys. Cooper Rush, who knows what was out there? A bunch of bums. No disrespect. They're NFL QBs, but they were not very good, not compared to Dak Prescott, who will be returning this year. Now, people seem to forget how good Amari Cooper was last year with Dak Prescott. I know it was the first 4 weeks, but everyone's just sleeping on this guy. They're just hyping up CeeDee Lamb. And I understand CeeDee Lamb's very talented, but you look at Amari Cooper through 4 full games with Dak Prescott last year, 37 receptions, 401 yards, and 1 touchdown. But even better, 9-plus targets in every single game. He averaged nearly 13 targets per game. He had 51 targets over that 4-game span. And icing on top, there was no wide receiver in the NFL that had more fantasy points than Amari Cooper through 4 weeks last year with Dak Prescott. Now, I'm not saying Amari Cooper, wide receiver 1, draft him. He will be the number one scoring receiver. He'll outscore Devontae Adams, Tyreek Hill, all that. I'm not saying that. But this is a guy that people are sleeping on. This guy's had 1,000 yards in 5 of his 6 seasons. And he was a wide receiver 10 in 2019 with Dak Prescott, wide receiver 15 last year, obviously. And he's played 14 games once in his career, 15 games once, and all 16 games in the other 4 career seasons. He's been pretty healthy, and maybe I'm jinxing him because he's had a small minor ankle injury, but he's expected to be fully back for the full season. He's a true wide receiver 1, and you're getting a hefty discount at wide receiver 15. His teammate, like I said, going wide receiver 11, I don't mind taking it. And heck, if CeeDee Lamb wants to be the number 1, take away the number 1 corner, by all means, go for it. I'll take Amari Cooper against the number 2 cornerback any day of the week. Count me in. The disrespect, gotta stop here for Amari Cooper. Wide receiver 15, a little bit too low. He's much better, I think, than the guys like Adam Thielen and Julio Jones going right next to him. I much rather have Amari Cooper on my team. Moved on to the Giants. And, man, Giants fans, plug your ears, because I'm not too optimistic on the Giants this season. Now, I could talk about Saquon returning from an ACL injury. Could talk about him, but he's still a top 5 running back who, if he slides in your draft, don't mind scooping him up. I've seen him slide in some of my drafts. And I've been scooping him up towards the end of the back half of the round 1 because this guy has the upside of, and he's got upside to be running back 1, and that's not outside of the realm of possibility. Now, I've already talked about Kenny Golladay, currently being drafted wide receiver 27. Yeah, will not have a lot of Kenny Golladay stock. No disrespect, just not in on him. Talk about Sterling Shepard. He is who he is. I mean, people want him to work out. Just hasn't really worked out too well. He's had some good games, had a lot of bad games. Not someone I'm targeting in fantasy football, hardly being drafted. Evan Engram, who I bet gets traded by the end of the season. Kyle Rudolph, no thanks. Darius Slayton, who's just a deep threat. And then he's had really good games his rookie year, and then fairly just no, he just doesn't look like he's out there half the time. Kadarius Toney, the rookie out of Florida, who I think will be good long-term in the NFL, maybe a good dynasty play, but there's so many different wide receivers. He's already dealt with an injury this preseason. I don't know what you want to do with that. So all things considered, then you got Daniel Jones, the turnover machine. Thus far in his NFL career, maybe he turns around this year. But all things considered, the Giants are one of those teams. I'm not going to choose one. They will be the first team that I will not choose a player because I don't know who you want me to talk about. I think their defense will be improved. You want me to talk about their defense? I'm not going to do it. So this is a team don't have a lot of stock in this season. Will they win games? Yeah, they'll win some games. Their defense, like I said, is pretty good. And that's led by Leonard Williams and other guys. They'll be pretty good on defense. And they're in the NFC East, so anything's possible. They're going to get a couple wins, probably free from the Washington football team or the Eagles, even the Cowboys, they could probably beat them here and there. So no disrespect to the Giants, but I just have not liked what I've seen out of Daniel Jones so far in his career. And I'm just not too optimistic on this offense besides Saquon to really turn it around. Some of those guys will have very good seasons, well, very good games, and maybe win you some games in like a best ball fantasy football format, but just not someone I'm targeting in my fantasy football snake drafts. Not a team I can necessarily rely on to get me fantasy points each and every week. So moving on, that'll do it for the NFC East. Hope you enjoyed. Let me know if I'm sleeping on someone in the comments below. Next week, we're going to cover the AFC West and NFC West, the final 2 divisions in the NFL. If you want to check out the previous divisions we've covered and maybe your favorite teams in them, like New York Jets we covered on Monday, go check them out down below. I appreciate you guys. I'll be back again Thursday for some more videos. My top 10 rankings, my QB running back, wide receiver rankings are coming out soon to get you guys prepared for your fantasy football drafts, which I'm sure are coming up in the next couple weeks. I appreciate you guys. This has been Austin, and I'll catch you guys again tomorrow. Peace out.